So guys, everything plastic has moved locations. They have a bigger spot now. The spot they had before was a little bit cramped, and I have permission. Nobody's really here, so we won't be getting in the way of any customers. We have permission to walk around and show it. I really like their new logo.
Me too.
It's really colorful. So the nice thing about everything plastic is that it's the East Coast version of cat plastic. We have to look at the tubing section. That's always the best stuff. We have opaque things. We have, I believe they have their own custom things from different jobs they've had to order. And so if you really need a whole bunch, if you want to spend thousands of dollars, you could get something probably custom made. If I understand right, they have a whole shop in the back with laser cutters and or whatever it is. You hear them doing work all back there, and they can do custom things for you. So if you want to have signage made or something, you know, like how Taco Bell always had that little plexiglass container that you'd put a coin in and it would be like a game, entirely made out of neon colored plexiglass. I imagine if you wanted that for your business, you could probably come here. Or if you want it for fun, you could probably come here and give them the design, and they would know how to put it all together for you. But for the makers such as you and I, they have, look at this, they have little tiny tubing. They also have this, which looks like it's ABS or something similar. They have solid rods. They have bigger tubing. And it's actually not that bad of price. They align the prices with reality very, very well. Because I've gone to some places and not the kind of place that a consumer would go to, but this is consumer prices. And these are just unobtainium. Even in California, I could not find these that well. Every soft and tap plastic would have one, but at Everything Plastic, they have them. So these are a bit of a spectacle. They're just in my mind when I come in here, like, wow, it's a place that sells huge acrylic tubes. It still feels so foreign to me. Oh. They just moved here, so some of the stuff, of course, is they're still organizing. This is a fresh, brand new store, but with all the old stuff. It's kind of amazing to get to see it. I just got a bunch of this stuff out of the trash. Sadly, the stuff I have it crumbles in my hand, so I'm gonna have to throw it away, but they have thin stuff. Oh, this is that rubber this is almost like a rubbery material. Almost like it, so you could make a screen, like an impact-resistant screen out of it. Oh, look at this. That's replicating that old type of window. Now that is interesting. It's like a custom molding. I can take that now. You know what this is? This is engravable material. So you engrave past it, and that's how you have like signs and stuff, because you have orange and white. So whenever you engrave, you get the white lettering on orange. So that's how you do that. You know, they probably have like lettering machines probably
in the 70s that did that. Have a pantomime, whatever. It's panta something. Looks like they haven't even put this stuff out yet. They're still sorting it. And not a bad price. Damn, it will not readjust. Oh well, this became an edited video. I was wanting to do a single shot, but the camera would not go back to autofocus. Oh, this is beautiful. Look at that. It's like a roughened texture.
Okay, check it out. Yeah.
I really like this. I would like to make brackets and stuff out of this. So this has the covering on it. Yeah. Oh, we have mirrored. We have mirrored plastic, non-glare, like Plaskolite. We have various colors. It looks like a neon. It has an iridescent feeling to it. Is this stuff in here too? Oh gosh, it is. Look at that. So I guess they've been getting a lot more material. Now they can actually have more stuff out here.
Mm-hmm.
We'll have to come back whenever they have more to show.
Yeah.
Oh, I love that they have it by color. Do they have a red one? They do have a red one. So for the laser cutter, we would need some clear red. Oh, this is cool.
Okay.
Oh, that's a rich red. Oh, this looks so weird through that. Here, look at this. Look at that.
Oh, that's cool.
I love that red. This one just looks like it absolutely is self-illuminating just from how neon it is. I mean, it is taking light in, but to our eyes, this is just fluorescent. It's amazing. This looks like the kind of color that you would get years and years ago that you'd have see stuff made from. It's like a very dull 80s color
mm-hmm.
or something like that.
Yeah.
Oh, I know. It reminds me of some bumpers on cars, how they would be a yellowish color when the paint would chip away.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Oh, this is an interesting color.
It's like that seafoam kind of.
Yeah. Huh.
Of course, you got your gold sparkle.
Is it?
Right here.
Oh, in there, right. Yeah.
Right here.
Plenty. Oh, whoops. Oh, this is interesting. It's like a marble. Is that, or is that just white?
Oh, I think it's just white.
Oh, it just has dust on it. Okay, never mind. All right, so we have thicker pieces. This is, I guess you call it blast shielding. Gosh, it just looks so illuminescent. There we have the white. Oh, yeah, you know, we probably will have to edit this video anyway just because there's going to be music in the background.
Yeah.
I forgot. You know, I was wanting to be lazy and do an unedited video, but...
No.
Yeah.
Not happening.
Oh, we have coroplast. Corrugated plastic. And then thick foam.
There's like some clear panels of it, too.
Yeah. Where? Oh, yes. The coroplast. I find these to be interesting. This is what makes me think they probably do custom stuff. Whoops. No. Although she mentioned they do, it costs a lot of money.
Yeah.
This has been here for a long time. Oh, they have more 1-inch tubes. That's good. Oh, yeah, look at that.
Yeah.
I think this was stuff from they had a big table.
Mm-hmm. Found our litter.
Mm-hmm. And they'll probably put a table out here to have all that kind of stuff on
that
it.
Way.
So these, I presume, are leftovers from various projects that they've had to do, like whenever they had to cut holes out. You can buy the offcuts. Plastic food.
Make me kind of hungry.
Reminds me of a few acrylic bakery containers that I from an actual bakery or candy store.
plastic cleaner.
Heavy scratch remover. And fine as well. Gaunt Industries. Don't know what that is. Hypo 200. I'll have to ask about that. Well, we have drill bits. Custom plastic drill bits. I've noticed that the drill bits for plastic, what was the term? They have a higher rake angle? I think it's called rake.
I can't recall.
So I just heard a bit of something that made me embarrassed. They moved here last year, like middle of last year. I can't believe it's been so long since we've been here. Last year was a time warp.
Oh my God, I know.
It's been months. I had no idea until now. I thought this was a more recent thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, this is a nice store. They so far have had every little bit of plastic accessories and materials that I could want. And there's been a few jobs that I've had with people. They've wanted odd ideas, and that required a lot of like 4x8 sheets of plastic. Now, that never came to fruition, but every single time I was able to get the plastic that I wanted. And that makes me really happy. Now, I actually have a job. A friend wants me to replicate the Lumaline light bulbs from the 1940s and 1950s, because his bathroom, their bathroom has this really beautiful fixture for Lumaline bulbs, but they haven't made Lumaline bulbs in forever. And replacement bulbs now are $123 at the lowest. So we've decided that we're gonna look for clear plastic tubing that we can spray paint on the inside, or possibly do the same thing that Technology Connections did, of coating the inside with glue or something to make it have an opaque finish. But look at this, they happen to also have opaque white tubing. This is exactly what I wanted. And they also have this. This will be in a future project. So they also said that they don't necessarily have a lot of time to figure out more displays. And I realized I really want to get rid of a lot of the wood that I have in the workshop. I'm going to see if I can make them a display. Just, that'd be a good way to get rid of some stuff, and maybe we'll have some of them you can have stuff on. That'd be pretty cool. Well, that is everything plastics. This is my new favorite plastic store for all plastic and polymer based materials. And I hope if you guys live on the East Coast, which turns out a lot of people live on the East Coast, whenever I make videos in the Midwest, nobody was in the Midwest, so nobody would use these recommendations. But on the East Coast, I know a lot of people are out here. You should visit Everything Plastic and maybe buy some scraps for your workshop. So guys, that's Everything Plastic. Or Everything Plastic, sorry. I keep pluralizing it. Their new logo. I love it. Because they do have a lot of colorful plastics. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you very much for watching.